Okay, welcome back. So moving on to question four, according to the well-architected framework, what change management steps should be taken to achieve reliability in the cloud? And you've got to select two of these. So again, it gets a little bit more complex here, but these aren't too difficult. So let's just go through them one by one to try and work out if they make sense. So AWS config to generate an inventory of resources. Well, that's exactly what you do with config. So you do use AWS config to generate inventories of your resources. So I like that option. We then got use service limits to prevent users from creating or making changes to AWS resources. Use service limits to prevent users from creating or making changes to AWS resources. Well, you can sort of apply service limits, which will stop anyone from being able to launch, you know, more than a specific amount of a resource. But does that prevent users from creating or making changes? No, it doesn't. They can still create them up to the limit, and they can still make changes to existing resources. So that doesn't make sense. The next one is use CloudTrail to record AWS API calls into an auditable log file. Well, that makes sense because, as we know, CloudTrail is all about auditing API activity. So it can do that, and it does record it into a log file. So I like that. We'll choose CloudTrail here. And by the way, in CloudTrail, you create what is called a trail, and then that can then be saved for long periods of time to make sure that you've got that auditing information. So the next one is use Certificate Manager to create a catalog of approved services. So AWS Certificate Manager is a service you can use to create and manage SSL TLS certificates. So those certificates for encrypting traffic to a web server, for example. Now, it's not used for creating a catalog of approved services. So that option doesn't make any sense to me. What about using GuardDuty to record API activity? Well, it does guard you, but not through API activity. You know, it looks at your resources and detects any kind of unauthorized activity. So let's click on check because I think those are good. And those are the correct answers. So let's move on to the next question. Which AWS cloud design principles can help increase reliability? So again, we're looking at reliability here. Now, you know, on your exam, it could be different, but that's why it's important to understand the well-architected framework. So how can we increase reliability? Do we use a monolithic architecture? Well, that typically refers to when, for instance, lots of different application components are running on a single server, like in the old days when you had mainframes. So that doesn't increase reliability because if that one system breaks, then you've got a bigger problem. By measuring overall efficiency, well, it would be good to measure efficiency. That might help you in cost management, in performance management, and so on, but it's not really related to reliability. What about testing recovery procedures? Well, all systems fail eventually. So when they do, you know, you want to make sure that you know how to recover them. If you haven't tested them, then you might have a big shock. So I like that one as an option. Now, a consumption model will obviously help you in terms of the way that you manage costs, but not reliability. And what about automatically recovering from a failure? So if a instance fails or, you know, a subnet fails or something like that, or maybe your application software fails, can your application automatically recover? And if it can, that's really going to help reliability. So I definitely like these two options. And those are correct. So let's go straight on to the next question. A startup e-commerce company needs to quickly deliver new website features in an iterative manner, minimizing the time to market. Which AWS Cloud feature allows this? So what gives them the ability to be able to very quickly deliver website features? And iterative just means, you know, they might have to make slight modifications. Maybe the customers prefer some slightly different way of doing things, or you get some feedback that means you've got to modify your application. So then you make small changes and you quickly get them back out again. And that's a way that people often operate in terms of development cycles today. And it's usually related to agility. So we call that the sort of agile DevOps method. So agility sounds like a good answer here. Elasticity is, as you know, it's more about scaling elastically. So for instance, an auto-scaling group that launches and terminates instances automatically. High availability is about being able to recover from failure so that individual breakages, systems going down, for instance, don't cause an outage for your application. And reliability is more about making sure, you know, your systems are more reliable so you don't have failures. So agility looks like the best option to me. Let's just check that one out, and that is correct. And I just want to head over to this table here to remind you of the 6 advantages of cloud. You've got to make sure you remember these for the exam, because these are critical for the cloud practitioner exam. AWS wants to make sure that you're really aware, you know, when you're out discussing AWS with other customers and other people, that you understand, you know, what are the real true benefits of using AWS. And you can see at number 4 here, we have increased speed and agility. So that's definitely a big factor.